Greetings. Thank you, Assam, for your question. I pray you understand the answer. And what is about Isaiah 44, verse 6? Is the God is two? Is there anyone besides him? To show respect to God, we show respect to his word as a whole, brother. I am so glad you have raised Isaiah 44, verse 6. Let us look together at what prophet Isaiah revealed. Isaiah 44, 6. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts. I am the first, and I am the last, and beside me there is no God. This verse is actually clear in its answer in the last phrase, brother. And beside me there is no God. The clarity of that phrase is that there is no other or separate God. But the phrase beside me can confuse some. In fact, there are two uses in English that sound similar, but are confused out of a lack of precision, laziness, if you will. The two that are confused are beside and besides. For example, my wife was standing beside me. Used this way, it means she was physically standing at my side, next to me. I won my university pool championship because no one besides me showed up. Used this way, it means other than me. I was the only student who showed up. In proper usage, the two are different. In common usage, they are often confused. In the Bible usage, King James Version, beside me would seem to be the first case, as in next to or physically by the side of. Tempting as that is, this requires a little more cogitation before the clearest meaning is revealed. If we blindly apply the first meaning for beside me, meaning next to, or more precisely, physically next to, this retains what I call weasel word usage. Weasel words are those words that sound true but carry a false meaning. One perfect example is when Bill Clinton said there is no sexual relationship with Monica Lewinsky. Bill was hiding behind a definition of is that means the present tense in an absolute sense. As Bill said there is no sexual relationship, Bill hid behind the moment he said it, he was not engaging in a sexual act with her. It would be weasel words for God to say, there is no other God physically beside me. That leaves open a potential for other gods that are simply somewhere else. But I do not think that is what Yahweh God was conveying. I believe he was saying, I am the only God in existence. However, that does not mean people do not worship other concepts and things as their gods. But people worshiping wooden idols or black stones from space does not make the object of their worship a real God. So what is God saying, and has he communicated that clearly? I believe he was saying, I am the only God in existence. Is that a possible interpretation of Isaiah 44, 6? Let's look at various translations of this phrase. King James says, and beside me there is no God. New International Version, apart from me there is no God. New Living Translation, there is no other God. English Standard Version, besides me, there is no God. Note usage of besides instead of beside. The New American Standard Bible, and there is no God besides me. Again, note usage of besides instead of beside. The Holman Christian Standard Bible, there is no God but me. International Standard Version, and apart from me, there is no God. .net Bible, "There is no God but me. It is clear I am the only God in existence," is a totally valid interpretation. The question then becomes understanding the first half of this verse in the context of this final meaning. "Any other God by any other name is no God at all, is a false pretender to the throne." In the first half, God has revealed an interesting detail regarding himself. "Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts." Both times the word Lord appears in all caps. The original Hebrew is God's personal name, Yahweh. I tend to read scriptures reintroducing the original and real name instead of the bashful substitution. "Thus saith Yahweh, the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, Yahweh, the Lord of hosts." In this verse, God reveals two descriptive names of Yahweh: Yahweh the King, or Yahweh Melech; Yahweh of hosts, called his Redeemer, Yahweh Sebaot. Yahweh God, who by the prophets has revealed he will redeem man, indicates in this verse, through a specific, separable reference, a portion of himself, of Yahweh, that performs this act of redemption. The important thing to understand, brother, is that God is revealing this, these details about himself. We show God respect by studying and striving to understand his message, not simply making his message fit into the way we want to think. First ideas are like sharp knives. We should not run with them. Christians believe there is one true God who made heaven and earth. There is only one God, and we respect his description and revelation of himself. In Isaiah 44:6, God says he is the first and the last, when he says, "I am the first and I am the last, and beside me there is no God." We believe God was before all things because he was the first. We believe what God revealed about himself, even if it does not fit our own ideas. God says he is the first and the last, through prophet Isaiah. And the Comforter who Jesus sent added more to the description of the one who is the first and the last. Revelation 2:8, "To the angel of the church in Smyrna write, these are the words of the first and the last." We know who the first and the last is: God. And from the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, we know the first and the last died and rose from the dead. The words of the first and the last who died and returned to life. We also know from the prophets that God says he will not share his glory with another, meaning another separate deity or God. Isaiah 42:8, "I am Yahweh, that is my name. I will not give or share my glory to or with another, or my praise to idols." We know that God will not share with another separate God, brother. We respect God, and this is what God's prophets have said. We also respect what Yeshua the Messiah taught, brother. And Yeshua the Messiah said things that were hard to bear and hard to accept. John 17:5, "And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you," meaning shared, "before the world existed." We know God will not share his glory with another separate God. And yet Yeshua the Messiah said he shared God's glory with God. God had shared his glory with Jesus before the world existed. This means Jesus is not another separate God, brother. If Jesus were another separate God, Yahweh God would not have shared his glory with Jesus. So we who believe the prophets and believe what Jesus said must recognize Jesus is one with God. And if you were brave enough to respect what Jesus said about himself, you too would believe. John 10:30, I and the Father are one. John 12:45, and whoever sees me sees the one who sent me, meaning God. Many times Jesus said specific things that imply unity with God at a level no prophet would dare claim. John 16:15, all that the Father has is mine. Therefore I said that he, meaning the comforter of the previous verse, will take what is mine and declare it to you. John 14:19, Jesus said to him, have I been with you so long, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? The disciples, taught by the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, also revealed the true description of Yeshua, the Messiah. John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John 1:18, no one has ever seen God, but the one and only Son, who is himself God, and is at the Father's side, has made him known. Colossians 1:15, the Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. I hope you now understand, brother, that Isaiah 44:6 does not infer or imply any other God exists other than Yahweh God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.